Hello everyone, in this video lecture we will learn how can we use operational amplifier as integrator and differentiator. In the first part of this video we will learn some basics of integrator and differentiator, and in the last part I am going to perform the practical in our laboratory. We know that operational amplifier is infinite input impedance device that has a very high voltage gain, and in last video we learned that there is no potential difference between these two terminals, that is between non-inverting terminal and inverting terminals, and this point acts as a virtual ground source. By connecting a resistor in the feedback circuit and a capacitor in the input circuit, we can convert a operational amplifier in a differentiator. As there is no current going inside the amplifier, the current going through the capacitor is also going through the resistor. So here Iin equal to If, that is the current going in the this direction, the same current is going in this direction, and we know that If equal to 0 minus V out by RF, and we know that the charge on a capacitor which is equal to C into V, that is what voltage. Here V means V in minus V0, and the current inside a capacitor is equal to dQ by dt, that is I in, which is equal to C dV by dt, V equal to V in. And from these two equation we can see that C dV in by dt, which is equal to minus V out by RF, and from here we can get V out, which is equal to minus RF into C into dV in by dt, and from here we can see that we can get a output, that is the differentiation of the input signal. And when we apply a sine wave as input signal, we can get a cosine wave as the output. And when we give a triangular wave as input signal, we get a rectangular wave as output signal. And when we apply a square wave as input signal, we get some spikes in the output signal. That is the differentiation of the square wave. And by just interchanging the position of capacitor and resistor, we can make a op-amp as integrator. In integrator circuit, we just place a capacitor in the feedback circuit and a resistor in the input circuit. And since there is no current going in this direction, I in, which is equal to IC, and we know that what is IC? IC is nothing but minus C dV out by dt, and what is IN? IN equal to V in minus 0 by R in. So from this equation we know that C into dV out by dt, which is equal to V in by R in, and from here we can get output, that is V out, which is equal to minus 1 by RF C integration of the input signal. So from here we can see that we can get a output, that is the integration of the input signal. Now I am going to perform this experiment in our laboratory.
This is our setup for operational amplifier. And here I am using op-amp as a differentiator, and for this I have connected a capacitor of capacitance 0.1 microfarad to the input of the amplifier, and I have connected a resistor of resistance 330 ohm as a feedback resistor to the operational amplifier. This is our function generator. This is our oscilloscope. Here, first I am using a sine wave with frequency 1 kHz, and I am giving this sine wave as a input through the capacitor into the operational amplifier. At the same time, I am giving this signal to the channel 1 of the oscilloscope, so that we can use this signal as a reference signal. And I am connecting the output of the operational amplifier to the channel 2 of the oscilloscope. And here we can see that this is our input signal, that is a sine wave, and this is our output signal as a cosine wave. We know that the differentiation of the sine wave or a sine function is cos function, but here we are getting cos minus cos x. It is because that a differentiator give us a differentiation of the input as a negative of the input. So here we are giving a sine wave or a sine function, and we are getting a cos function, but with negative sign. And as I change sine wave to a triangular wave, we know that differentiation of a triangular wave is a square wave. So we can see this input signal as a triangular wave, and this is our output after differentiation in the shape of square wave. And we know that the differentiation of a square wave is some spikes. So we can see in the display that we are giving a square wave, and we are getting some spikes as the resultant of our output. So here we can see that by using a capacitor and a resistance, we can use operational amplifier as a differentiator. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you. In a similar manner, we can use operational amplifier as an integrator. For this, I have to connect capacitor into the feedback circuit, and we have to give input through a resistor. Here I am using a resistor of 330 ohm and a capacitor of 0.1 microfarad. I am using a sine wave of frequency 1 kHz as input signal, that is given to the input of the operational amplifier through this resistor. At the same time, I have connected this input to the channel 1 of the oscilloscope, and I have given the output of this integrator to the channel 2 of the oscilloscope. And here we can see, when I am giving sine wave as an input, we are getting a cosine wave as output. And when I am giving a square wave as input, we are getting a triangular wave as an output. So in this way, we can use an amplifier as an integrator. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you.